Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Enhanced Edition Blind. Number one, Kagan burps a lot. Number two, I lied at the land of last episode. I was going to head into Baldur's Gate, but I found if we go north from here, we can hit these farmlands. At least that's what's called on the map. Farmlands. Ooh, and Ulgoth's beards. I guess we'll go to either of those. 8 hours. Not tired, I hope. We'll check out the farmlands here. A river runs the
road. Why me?
Zombies. Whoa.
Go for the ice pool.
My blade will cut you down to size.
So, what I really wanted to do is take care of all these outside areas before we go into Baldur's Gate itself. So, it's another outside area. Who we got? Zombies again. There's a couple of them.
Tempus, give us victory!
Whoa, you killed me. More zombies.
Go for the ice, Boo! Go for the ice! Rusk!
Was I trying to save? I think I inadvertently tried to save. Moo cows. Hello, Moo cow.
My blade will cut you down to size.
Oh, we didn't even get to him. Some kind of barn or something? If we can get in here. We can't get over this. There's some kind of wall built up here. We can't get in here. So it's a farm beside it with zombies. Here's someone named Wenick. Okay, get through the fence. Of course, makes sense. Hello, Wenick. Hello, pal.
Hello, pal.
How did I know? There's been something killing people's in around the farms here. Zombies or something. Well, zombies. I can understand if you can't stomach the task, but just between you and me, real personal likes, I don't know who else is going to do it. All of us have been going for a week now without sleep. We've counted 20 zombies or so, so keep track as you kill them, if that's what you plans on doing. Once you got them all, come back here and I'll give you the 150 gold pieces that some of us have pooled together. Okay. A zombie infestation has been terrorizing the few settlers unlucky enough to own land by the river. An old farmer by the name of Wenrick has counted 20 of them and will pay me an impressive 150 gold pieces if I can get rid of every last one. Well, hope you don't mind if we take a look about. I don't know how many we killed. Maybe 8? 10?
Hello, pal.
Looks like I told you to count them zombies as you kill them. You still got a few to go. How would you know?
Alright.
Alrighty then. It's all locked.
Good job.
Ooh. A magical cloak of some kind.
A simple matter.
Needs to be identified.
All right.
Yep, Robin, I'm blind. Pearl necklace.
A simple matter.
All right.
I'll leave you the long sword. I'm feeling generous today. Oh, she went outside by herself.
Sure.
I wonder about this cloak.
Why me?
I love a good magic cloak. I like how when the cow moves, its little circle lights up. Cow and chicken. Oh, we haven't identified this thing yet. I give it to me. Flail plus one. We'll be selling that.
Why me? Altruistic moron?
Am I? Has our reputation gone back up? We're still average 10. Not that bad. Just killing zombies anyway. Let's check up here.
For right.
Farmland turned into zombie land. Can't walk on that. I have to stay on the grass. Yeah. There's some more zombies.
All right.
Mince actually got hit. Can walk through there. Dog of War. All right, well, this is mostly this, and we're almost done. Wenrick's house. Well, quite easy foes so far. I mean, zombies are nothing to us now. Can I walk around that? Yeah. This way. Surely there'd be something to challenge us around here. Other than zombies? Nope, just zombies. This weapon is unusable. My weapon is unusable. It's usable. What's this? Abilities. The selected item has all the abilities listed above. You can change the currently selected ability by clicking on one. I don't know what that does. Saved. Alright. We can't even walk there. Sliver of Fog of War. Oh, we must get rid of this. Sorry, guys, it's mandatory. There we go. So I can walk on here. Alright. Any more zombies? Yes. Answer, yes. Well, this unused space drives me insane. That's it. Let's look down here. I figured we'd find anything, but just in case. Hopefully we've killed, what, 20 of them we needed? That's kind of a small area. Unless this guy's gonna also reward us by giving us a boat, maybe we can go over to some island or something in the middle. Kinda doubt that. Well, I've turned your farmland back into zombie land again. Thanks. That's been real generous of yous. Maybe we all can finally get a wink of sleep yet. Here's that 150 gold pieces we promised yous. If we had more, we'd give them to you. Well, there's only one problem. There's only one of you. A reward of 150 gold pieces for destroying 20 zombies seems a little low. Perhaps I should have what? Reneged? Done quests. Perhaps I should have bargained. Really? I didn't see an option to bargain about that. So it also looks like we can get to Ulgoth's beard now. So I don't want to cut this episode at 15 minutes. Like, tiniest area ever. And I'm not completely sure if we should go to... If we should go to, what do you call it? Forget the name. What? Come on. Can't head north off of here? Can we head east? Should I bother going that way? Well, anyway, not sure if I should go into Baldur's Gate next or go to Durlag's Tower. That's what I couldn't remember. Let's try to head east out of here then. I don't know why. Look and see. You gotta be kidding me.
Boo likes the forest.
He does, huh? I think we gotta head out the way we came for some reason. This is not really forest, though, Boo. Peek over here. Yep. We have to go this way. Why, I have no idea. Should probably be a good place to rest, actually. Good. There's nothing here except for those zombies. So now I can head to Ulgoth's Beer, which takes 24 hours to travel anyway. Ooh. The village of Ulgoth's Beer lies on the banks of the river Chiantara. Just upstream from Baldur's Gate and the open sea beyond, this farm-dotted countryside is usually a peaceful haven from the turmoil of the Sart coast, although of late the same cannot be said of Ulgoth's Beard itself. The simple fishing village has become the source of many a rumor in recent days, rumors of an ancient cult risen again, unsubstantiated tales of a murderous creature stalking the night, and talk of strange goings-on in the House of Chandelar. The powerful and eccentric mage who makes his home in a normally sleepy village. Chandelar. Well, if he's friendly, maybe he can help us with that egg. You have also heard with certainty that tours of the fabled Durlag's Tower operate from Ulgoth's Beard. Tours? And that it is truly a place where adventurers can test their mettle. Perhaps such a test will better prepare you to fight the darkness that threatens to destroy the Sword Coast, and you with it. Really? Okay.
Why me?
Dushai and a commoner. And a chicken. Hello, commoner.
You don't look like you're from around here.
Miserable day it is. I think I got Soon's horizontal dancing disease from Mistress Mallory. Too shy?
Your acquaintance I am glad to have made.
I'm trying to meditate, adventurer. Come and see me later. Ike? Let's talk to Ike, I guess.
Step right up! Step right up!
Oh, brother.
Step right up! Step right up!
Step right up, folks, and hear the tale of the dread placed before thee. Join with me as I, adventure extraordinaire, Ike Cascadian Vendar, lead yet another group of brave souls to the very seat of danger in the realms. To Durlag's Tower we shall go, and witness the perils that have taken the lives of hundreds of courageous men and women. See the horror of the treacherous traps, feel the presence of the long-languishing dead, marvel at the wondrous wealth buried below. Not for the weak of heart, as I will not be held accountable for any heart failure during or after the expedition. Step up, one at a time. I'm not ready to go there yet. Hello to you, my friends. Come see the lengths the wealthy must go, just to protect their fortunes. 'Tis a life I'd wish on no one. Just 80 gold for your entire group, and I don't do this for everyone. I'm not interested in your adventuring tours, Huckster. Yes, the tower scares away the best of us. I'll be leaving here daily, if you find your spine. I met a blustering lout. Offering tours of Durlag's tower. It seems he aims to make a tourist attraction out of the death trap. I decided not to take him up on his offer, but he will be available if I change my mind. What do we want a tour for? Is he going to help us fight the undead there and stuff? Because I think there's undead there. Let's like look around real proper-like.
Hergen would speak at you, so listen up a moment or two.
Okay. Hergen Stoneblade. A merry band of heroes you be. Have I got the adventure that'll make you yearn for glory? I am Hergen Stoneblade, presently residing in Citadel Adbar. Well met. What adventure do you speak of? A glorious adventure indeed. You have heard of Durlag's Tower, perhaps? Yes, I've heard of it. It's a haunted tower to the south of here, is it not? It was haunted by me granddad's friend for a time. He went mad, you see. Durlag Trollkiller was a dwarven hero of great renown. Single-handedly slew many a dragon, he did. Me granddad was a good friend of Durlag's. They adventured together until me granddad's untimely death several centuries ago. Go on. Me granddad was slain by an evil demon, but Durlag survived. Durlag kept Soul Taker that had been me granddad's. He was going to send it to my mother, but he was betrayed. A sad tale, that. After Durlag built the tower, his family was replaced by doppelgangers. Durlag killed them all, but was driven mad by the act. He entrapped the tower heavily and forgot about me granddad's dagger. When I heard the story as a youth, I went to retrieve the dagger myself, but was driven back by Durlag's devious traps. If you be interested, I wish to hire you to retrieve me granddad's dagger, Soul Taker, me birthright. The tower has been penetrated somewhat by previous adventurers. I would think that the edge has been taken off the danger. What say you? Perhaps we should speak of compensation. Of course. I have an enchanted hammer. 'Tis a powerful weapon in its own right. Should you have no use for it, then I reckon it'll bring an excellent price. What say you? It's a fair price. We shall find your dagger. Good fortune to you, then. I shall await your return here. Hergen Stoneblade has asked me to enter Durlag's tower and retrieve an enchanted dagger called Soul Taker, a family heirloom. These people are really interested in stuff concerning Durlag's tower. Gulkin. There's a bartender. Oh, and that's a commoner. Oh, and here's a Hergen Stoneblade.
Sure.
Welcome to our little village.
You'll have to excuse me. I have to feed Bert. Who is Bert? Me sea bass. Oh, okay. Miserable day it is. Oh, yeah, we heard it.
Well, now I'll talk to you if you want.
What?
Well, now I'll talk to you if you want.
Oh, he has a sea bass as well. Okay.
What are you bothering me for?
Don't tell her that I said so, but I hear that Mistress Mallory has the Calamshan itch. Alright, Gulkin?
Will no one take me over? Bah, you're all name in it all.
Hey, how'd you like to be supping on fine venison and tipping back the good stuff? I have the key to Wealth Legendary if you're up for it. Hear me out, and the rest of these sods will be tugging on your coattails for loose copper someday. Tell me more, good sir. Ah, even adventurous spirit in you. No doubt you've heard of the labyrinth of Durlag's Tower, huh? And how she's been pillaged so often that fap nobles go there for picnics? Well, the tower has, but below are dungeons untouched. I've a token, a ward token to be sure, that gives entry to them. 'Tis yours if you'll but settle my tab so I can leave this fine place with all my limbs intact. Where did the likes of you get this? Like all things, it had an owner before me, and who does not have it now? 'Tis none of your affair what incurred in between. Shall you own it next, or no? How much of a tab is at stake? Oh, 'tis but a meager sum. I'm embarrassed I cannot cover it myself. 900 gold and I'm off the hook. What say, chum? Sure, why not? It'll help us with that place, I guess. You have a deal, sir? We certainly can spare it. Ah, bless your kindness. I'm off to pay my bill before I suffer any more interest, of either sort, from the innkeep. Oh, by the by, while I am quite certain he could not find me here, the former owner of that little trinket may well be keeping an eye over Durlag Way, to see if he can spot someone using it. Just thought I'd pass along the warning, since you did me this favor. I'm sure he'll listen to reason, though. I'm sure. Galkin's Wardstone. I bought a ward token from that scoundrel Galkin, and I should have guessed there would be strings attached. He said it is truly a key for some door or another deep in the tower, but the former owner might be looking for it too. With my luck, he stole it from Durlag himself, or from some other powerful being. Well, here it is. Wardstone. Unidentified, often marked with magical glyphs, runes, or symbols, wardstones are powerfully enchanted items intended to grant their bearer passage through magically guarded areas. As most wardstones are quite unique and specific in their nature, it is rare to find one with more than one purpose. I got some stuff to identify. Yeah, these two things. I got quite a lot of bandit scalps now. Bullets plus one. Alright. I can't save it this time. Look, is we're in here? Bartender.
You want some whiskey?
If you got a good coin to spend, I can set you up with whatever you need. I have all that an adventurer may need. What can I get for the lot of you? That would depend on what you have to offer. Ooh, acid arrows. Bullet plus two, look at that. That's a level 4 spell. Mental domination. Not usable by mage. Oh, so this is a... cleric? A druid, maybe? Emotion. Level 4. When this spell is cast, the wizard can disturb the emotional state of those around her. The effect of this is to inflict a feeling of hopelessness upon the enemies within the visual range of the caster. Upon a failed saving throw versus a spell, the affected creature will lie down where they stand and give over all their will to a higher power. Sometimes they can be heard to exclaim things such as, I lay down and die, or I'm going home. This will last for the duration of the spell, upon which they return to normal. The secondary effect of the spell is to instill upon the caster the feeling of courage. This will remove any effects of panic and restore her morale, as well as prevent the above from creeping forth into her psyche. There is no saving throw versus this, and it will last for the duration of the spell. It will, however, be affected by magic resistance and other such things. Well, I think if we have an effect of panic, I don't think we can cast that. Greater malaise. This spell allows the caster to adversely affect all the saving throws of her enemies. The effect is applied to all hostile creatures within the area of effect. Opponents under the influence of the spell must make all saving throws at a penalty of -4. I'm getting that. Improved invisibility. Good to cast on our thief. The spell is similar to invisibility, but the recipient is able to attack by missile discharge, melee combat, or spell casting while remaining unseen. However, telltale traces, a shimmering, allow an observant opponent to attack the invisible spell recipient. These traces are only noticeable when specifically looked for after the invisible character has made her presence known. Attacks against the invisible character suffer a -4 penalty to attack rolls, and the invisible character's saving throws are made with a +4 bonus. Note, after making an attack, the wizard is no longer completely invisible. Opponents can target the wizard. What? That makes no sense. Okay. The wizard is no longer completely invisible. The recipient is able to attack by missile discharge, melee combat, or spell casting while remaining unseen. After making the attack, the wizard is no longer completely invisible. Or no longer completely invisible. Okay. Only noticeable when specifically looked for, etc. Okay. So you still got that -4 penalty and +4 saving throws. Got it. That adds up. Two things. Animate dead. That's level 5. Shadow door. Ooh. Really? By means of this spell, the wizard creates the illusion of a door. The illusion also permits the wizard to appear to step through this door and disappear. In reality, she has darted aside and can flee, totally invisible, as per the improved invisibility spell for the spell's duration. A true seeing spell, a gem of seeing, or a similar magical means can reveal the wizard. That's interesting. But that's level 5. I don't have that yet. Polymorph other. Ooh. Powerful magic that permanently alters the form of the creature affected. Mental attributes are not affected and the target does not receive the special abilities of the new form. However, all physical attributes are changed to adhere to this new form. There's a specific version of the spell in that the recipient will be transformed into a squirrel unless a save versus petrification polymorph is made successfully. The transformation is instant and permanent until a dispel magic is cast successfully on the affected creature. The natural attacks of this new form also become available, and all clothes and equipment that the target was wearing will mold into the new form. I don't see the... I'm not sure how that affects right now, how that, Flame Strike is cleric. I'm not sure how useful that is. I'll take a raise dead, at least one. Potions of healing, we need those. Cloak of displacement. Magical item that causes subtle shifts in the image of its wearer. It has the power to actually shift an individual's image by as much as 6 inches in any direction from their actual location. Aside from being an effective defense in combat situations, has also been the cause of serious eye strain amongst fellow party members. Armor class plus 4 versus missile attacks. Save versus death, breath, and wand plus 2. Not usable by who? Wizard's Lair. Aeol's staff plus 1. Again, Durlag's Tower. These people are obsessed. This finely crafted staff was among the spoils taken from the invaders of Durlag's Tower. It was very deadly in combat and was apparently the property of a spellcaster that enjoyed standing on the front lines. It appears to have a core of iron, yet it is comparable in weight to a normal weapon of its type. Part of the enchantment seems to come from the hide that strengthens the grip, leather no doubt made from a battle-ready creature of some sort. With the tastes and inclinations of the attackers of the tower well documented, the hide could be almost anything, or anyone. Thaco plus 3, 1d6 plus 3, crushing. Quarterstaff. The captive audience. Gregan's harp. This finely made harp is well known among the nomadic peoples of the East, though more for the infamy of its owner, Gregan of Lowhill. He was a bard of sorts, though less for his love of people than his hatred of hard work. He bade a mage relation construct this harp so its magic might disguise his utter lack of talent in the arts. Its power was greater than he had hoped, and he later turned to petty burglary using his music to captivate his victims. Gregan ultimately disappeared some years ago amidst rumors of a bardic college uncharacteristically moved to violence. The harp still functions, though any self-respecting troubadour would reserve its use for the most dire of circumstances. The magic seems to be waning as well, and perhaps this is one item best lost to time. Alright, so if you had a bard or any of these, that would be helpful. Wand of the Heavens. Ooh. Flame Strike. This wand will cause a pillar of flame to shoot out of the sky and strike the chosen target. The flames will do 8d6 damage to the target, with ones taken as twos. Unless the target makes a save versus wand, in which case she will take half. The wand only has a certain amount of charges and be destroyed when they are used. Wand of Frost, we know it well. Sand Thief's Ring. Ring of Invisibility. Held by a master thief for the better part of a generation, this ring was put to best bold use in the markets of Waterdeep. Working a crowd in broad daylight, the rogue would steal countless numbers of purses from nobles, replacing them with bags of sand so the theft would go unnoticed. His identity was never known, but the name Sand Thief was cursed loudly in its stead. It is rumored he retired and now lives among the nobles he used to rob. Invisibility is for the namesake spell. It's got 7 charges. Greenstone Amulet. This deep green stone at the center of the amulet seems to shimmer with an iridescent light, almost as if it has a life of its own. Even without the powerful magics that are bestowed upon the amulet, it would be an extremely valuable addition to any collection. This amulet confers the wearer protection against charm, confusion, fear, domination, ESP, detect alignment, hold, stun, psionics, sleep and feeble mind, much like the eighth level wizard spell Mind Blank. However, the protection effect uses one charge each time it is used and will only last for one turn. That would be good for Minsk, but I would want to save that, actually. It's only got 10 charges. Unless we can find more of them. Bolt of Polymorphing? This bolt has been enchanted with powerful magic, glowing slightly with almost a green inner light. If the bolt finds its target once it is fired, the target must make a save versus polymorph or be transformed into a squirrel. Target must save versus polymorph or be turned into a squirrel permanently. That's awesome.